the B-25 north of this building. It's kind of the anchor because it ties the museum and everything that's come later with the original Pampa Army Airfield. That was a training base out here during World War II. We have a Nordant bomb site, which is very unusual. During World War II, it was a device that they attached to the bombers, and it was classified for many, many years. In fact, the crew was told that if it looked like the aircraft was going to be lost, they were to destroy it. The bombardier would actually put in airspeed, altitude, and other information into the analog computer. And, you know, to hear that term used from the 30s and 40s is unheard of. And then when they got close to the site, the machine itself would take control of the autopilot of the aircraft. We have a UH-1 Huey, which served in Vietnam. And it's got some bullet holes in it. It was a troop carrier cargo aircraft. Just about everything in here has been donated by someone who's lived in the Panhandle area, or was born and raised here, or went to the air base. We've got a couple of doctors that have provided items. We have one on our board who recently retired, and he served in Iraq. And he always, when we have the students coming, he's one of our volunteers. And he loves to show them the hazmat suit that's in the corner over there and tell them about how he would have to wear one of those suits while he examined and treated his patients. I would hope it gives them a sense of education of our history. You know, military history goes back to the beginning of time. And if you don't learn it, if you don't remember it, you repeat it.